are going to see how sexual reproduction takes place, okay? And the importance of that kind of reproduction. And why do we perform that kind of reproduction, okay? You know that there are two kinds of reproduction, asexual and sexual reproduction. In asexual, in asexual reproduction, okay, only one individual take part on it. And what happens is that it can divide, okay, and form a new individual, or it can bud, okay, it can form a bud and generate a new individual, which is identical, okay, to the other individual, just identical, okay, there won't be any difference, any genetic or physical difference. In sexual reproduction, what happens is that two individuals take part on it, okay, and the new individual is going to have a characteristics of both parents, okay. We perform that kind of reproduction for generating, okay, a genetic difference in our population. We need to create genetic differences, okay, diversity, genetic diversity in our population. Obviously, it's easier to perform asexual reproduction, okay, but sexual reproduction is going to be better, is more difficult, okay, but it's going to be better because the new individuals are going to have new genetic characteristics. Now, for understanding how does it happen, okay, we are going to review that. As you know, we are made of organs, okay? And those organs are made of tissues, like the muscle tissue, nervous tissue, connective tissue. All that kind of tissues are made of cells. Here we have the tissues and the cells. As you can see, all cells have the nucleus with the DNA, okay? The cells have all the organelles, obviously, and they have a nucleus, and inside the nucleus is the genetic material. So now we are going to see the genetic material. Now here we have a cell with its nucleus, and inside is the DNA. The DNA, as you know, it has a double helix structure. What does it mean? It has two chains, okay, it's made of two chains, and attached to those chains are the nitrogenous bases, which are adenine, thymine, cytosine, and guanine. Those bases act like an alphabet. We have all the information in every single cell in our body is the same information of the DNA, okay? They have the same DNA, the same genes. So that information is contained there, and I tell you that they act like an alphabet because if you want to look for information, you are going to read a text, and that text can have hundreds or thousands of words, but there are only 27 different letters in the alphabet. And if we go to the Hawaiian alphabet, they only have 8 different letters, and with only 8 different letters, they can make a language with thousands of words. Just think, in Hawaiian words, Aloha, Hawaii, Waikiki. So with these 4 nitrogenous bases, DNA carry the information and it can be read, okay? We can read all the cells read the DNA, okay, and they know what they have to do or what proteins do they have to build. Another important thing is that one chain and the opposite chain are more or less the same, because adenine always is opposite to thymine and cytosine to guanine. Why? You can see that here we have adenine, we have in this chain adenine, cytosine, thymine, guanine, thymine, thymine, adenine, cytosine, guanine, thymine, okay? And if you take a look to the opposite one, you have you can see that we have, where is the adenine, we have thymine, where is the cytosine, we have guanine, okay? They are opposite like this, but the information is the same, because you can read it and you can know, if you read this chain, you can know the information of the other chains. Okay, so now maybe you have heard about chromosomes. What are chromosomes? That's something about genetics, no? Yeah, but genetics is DNA. So chromosomes, in fact, are DNA. In a normal situation, DNA inside a cell is like this, and we say that is diffused, okay? It's diffused DNA. It's here, okay, and it's diffused. But when the cell is going to divide, okay, when this cell is going to divide by a sexual reproduction, because they can divide, they double the DNA, and they take half and half, and they divide. For doing that, they have to organize this DNA into chromosomes. They have to organize it, okay? So what do? They, firstly, they take the DNA, okay, this DNA, they are going to roll up it, okay? They are going to roll up like this. If this is the chain, okay, the double chain, okay, they are going to start rolling up, just like this. They roll up, 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 they roll up. And also, they double, okay? I told you that they double the DNA. So here, it does the same. They have doubled it, no? So they roll up, they roll up, they roll up, they roll up. And here, they link. And this is a chromosome, okay? A chromosome is a lot of DNA which has been rolled up, and it has like two arms, okay, that they are just the same, because this one is copy of this one. Okay, now we have in humans, we have 23 pairs of chromosomes. And you maybe have heard about chromosome X and chromosome Y. Okay, more or less, all of them have an X shape, okay, like this, because they are something like this, okay? You would drag. Oh, I have a chromosome here. I want to show you. Some student did that. It's a magnet for the fruits, and it's a chromosome, okay? They have this shape, okay? It's like this. So this is the DNA, okay, that has been rolled up, and this is the same DNA, a copy, okay, a copy of the double chain, another copy for dividing. When cells are going to divide, they double their chain, okay? This double chain, because this is a double chain, they make another double chain, okay? They double it, okay? They reproduce it the same, and it's being rolled up. So I hope so far so good till here. This all about chromosomes. We have 23 pairs of chromosomes in our cells. 23 pairs. When our cells are going to divide, they Firstly, they multiply this DNA, okay, they double it, and they organize it in chromosomes. We have 23 pairs, which is 46 chromosomes. So now I'm going to explain you why do we say that we have 23 pairs instead of saying that we have 46, no? Because maybe you are going to think, but why are you thinking that we have pairs? What are their pairs? Like this pair, this is a pair, this is not one and two. I'm going to explain you now, okay? Here, we're going to see how occurs a normal cell division. This kind of cell division, okay, I have called it normal, but it should be called somatic cell division, okay? And this kind of division occurs when our cells need to divide for creating new tissue or for repairing a harmed tissue, for growing. And what happens is that cells make a copy just like them. And what is going to happen? That DNA is going to double, okay? This is going to make a copy of it, okay? It makes a copy just the same. It doubles, and then it organizes into chromosomes. You can see. And this is just the same as this, okay? This information is the same as this information. And this is the same as this one, because the DNA has been doubled. Okay, now the cell divides into two cells, and you can see that chromosomes are going to divide here, and half of them are going to these cells, and half of them are going to the other cell. And now we have two cells with the DNA, okay? They have this quantity of DNA. This in this case is not double, but when this cell is going to divide again, okay, they are going to double the DNA. Okay, so I hope you are understanding this. Okay, this is not so difficult. But now we are going to the gametogenesis. Gametes are the sexual cells. In the case of animals, are ovums and spermatozoans. So, when our body is going to make spermatozoans or produce ovums, okay, we have a different kind of cells which are called sexual cells, okay, and these kind of cells are going to divide for creating those spermatozoids or those ovums. It's the same just like this. They are going to double their DNA. The cell doubles its DNA into the chromosome. But take care, because here the chromosomes are going to divide by the arms. And the arms, one arm and the other arm, are just the same as we. If we take a half of us, this half is the same as this half. It's just the same, okay? But in this case, the chromosomes are going to stay here by pairs, okay? They are by pair, they are pair. And when the cell divides, it divides here, and half of the chromosomes are going to a cell, and the other half are going to the other cell. What is going to happen? That these chromosomes, this information is the same as this, okay? But not the same as this one. This information is not the same as this one. Two chromosomes are not the same, but two arms of the chromosomes are just the same. So here we have half of the information. It is doubled, okay? It is doubled because we have two arms in each chromosome. It is doubled, but it's not the same information as this. So now, it's going to happen a second division. In this second division, this here happens the same, okay? In this second division, the cell is going to divide by here, like here. It's going to separate the arms of the chromosomes. And these cells are the same. These cells have the same information because they come from the same chromosomes. This and this is the same, and this and this. The same happens with this. But these cells are not like these cells. Okay? They are different because they have three chromosomes, and here there are three chromosomes. What has happened? Here we have six chromosomes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and six. I failed. Six chromosomes, okay? And in this one, we have six chromosomes with only one arm, but there are six chromosomes. We called N, the letter N, to the name of chromosomes. Here, N equals 6, and here, N equals 6. But the case here is different because we start with a cell with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 chromosomes. N is 6 chromosomes, but these cells have 1, 2, 3. N equals 3 chromosomes. They have a half of chromosomes. And these cells are the ones that they are going to mature, okay? They are going to mature, and they are going to transform into ovums, in the case of women, and spermatozoon in the case of men. Okay? So, ovums and spermatozoons have the half of the genetic material. They have the half of the of chromosomes. Now, we are going to the next step. So now, we have the spermatozoon in the case of male and the ovums in the case of female. And maybe you are wondering, but why do ovums and spermatozoons have a half of the genetic material or the half of the chromosomes? Because when fertilization occurs, okay, when the spermatozoon reaches the ovum, they fuse their nucleus and they are going to have the chromosomes of the mother and the chromosomes of the father. And it doubles. So when we produce spermatozoons or ovums, we divide it, okay, we halve the number of chromosomes in order to, when fertilization occurs, we don't have the double number of chromosomes. And so this is a zygote. The cell that is formed when fertilization occurs is called zygote. So now what's going to happen? This zygote is going to divide in the normal division. In normal division, okay, what's going to happen? That the DNA is going to be doubled. As you can see, they double, and the division occurs, and they separate the arms of the chromosomes, and half for one side, half for the other side. Then we have two cells joined together, okay? And then this is going to happen the same. They are going to double, and they are going to divide. Double, divide, double, divide, double, divide. In a normal division, okay? They double the DNA, and then they divide. So they are going to form a mass of cells which are called embryo. These cells, okay, are going to difference into different kind of cells. They are called stem cells. Stem cells. In Spanish we call them células madre, mother cells, because they are not differentiated, okay, they are not differentiated by but they are going to transform, they can transform into any other kind of cell. In fact, they are going to transform into epithelial cells, muscle cells, all kind of cells, and they are going to create the new individual. And this new individual, why do we say that it has 23 pairs of chromosomes? Because half of the chromosomes come from the father, and the other half come from the mother, as you can see. Yeah? So that's why we say that we have 23 pairs, because half of them comes from our father and the other half comes from our mother. And so I think there's no, I hope there are no, there's no doubt about this. And now, in case of any, I'm going to explain what happens, because you always ask me this question in this lesson. What is the difference or between twins and identical twins? Okay, twins come from two ovums, okay? In the ovary makes an ovum each month. One month works an ovary, and the other month works the other ovary, and they make only one ovum. But sometimes they make two ovums. So when we have two ovums, they are going to be fertilized by two spermatozoons, two ovums and two different spermatozoons. So this is different and this is different. So these twins are going to be like brothers. Yeah, genetically, they are going to be like brothers. But because during the division of gametogenesis, the chromosomes, you know that the number of chromosomes halves. So as they halves, they can, this spermatozoon can have some chromosomes or other chromosomes, okay? Because it has the half. The genetic material is not always the same. So when they are twins, they are like brothers, because there are two different ovums and two different spermatozoons. But in the case of identical twins, what happens is that there are one ovum and one spermatozoon, and they are, this is fertilized, okay? Fertilization occurs, and we have one zygote. Only one zygote. And this has this genetic material, okay? Half of the father, half of the mother, but this genetic material. When this zygote starts dividing, okay, in the first steps of dividing, sometimes these two cells can separate, because I told you that they are joined together, they are joined. But if you separate them, okay, or if they separate, what is going to happen? They separate, and they are going to divide and form. This one is going to form an embryo, and this other one is going to form another embryo. But this embryo is just the same like this, because this genetic material is the same. It's just the same. It comes from the same zygote. So these are identical twins. They have the same genetic material.